We report on a lot of numbers when it comes to tracking COVID-19.
And one thing we've been hearing more about lately is the positivity rate. So what does that mean? Where does Minnesota stand? Why don't you start with positivity? We're talking about positive tests, right?
Right. We're talking about the percentage of positive tests versus the overall tests that are taken. And for a while, we couldn't really talk about the positivity rate because we weren't doing enough testing. And now that we're doing a lot more testing than we used to, the positivity rate makes more sense to look at as to whether or not our cases are really growing and could grow out of control.
Because this does go to what President Donald Trump said,
right,
which was widely ridiculed because it sounds silly that we have more cases because we have more tests.
Mm-hmm.
But the reality is we do have more reported positive case
and
because
we're doing more tests. Right, but when you look at the percentage of it.
Yeah, there are positive cases out there, like the cases are there whether you're testing or not.
Absolutely.
But as far as a useful data point goes, sometimes just the raw number of cases, you don't really know.
No.
Is this good? Is it bad?
Is it good?
What does it mean?
If you don't know what happened yesterday and you're not sure of the trend and you're not sure how many people have been tested. So this is a good metric that they look at. Of course, it's not the only one. It's a big one, but they also look at ICU bed usage, hospitalization, how much spread there is in the community is a big one for them as they make these decisions on dialing back or opening up or schools or anything like that.
What are kind of the benchmarks here?
Right. Okay. So right now we are at a 4.7% rolling average. You kind of do it over a 7-day average because you don't want one day really to spike. They say 5% is really that line where you really need to start, you know, taking serious consideration into it. Here in Minnesota, if we go over 15%. For a week, then they will consider dialing back from where we are now. If we go up 5% from that every day for 14 days. So they have very specific numbers of what they're looking at every day.
And the positivity rate is useful because we're running so many tests a day.
Exactly.
That it feels like it's a broad sample.
Exactly.
It's not just sick people who are being tested now.
But I talked to a Dr. Michael Osterholm over at the U, who's obviously, you know, world renowned on this. And I said, well, is 5% okay? And he said, well, truly nothing is okay.
Of course.
But think about this. He said, Florida went from 5% to almost 20% in just 3 weeks. Arizona, Mississippi, Texas, a lot of these states, it went up fast. I asked the Department of Health about that yesterday. They said, look, we're not as wide open as those other states were, but it is certainly something that they were thinking about because that number can just go from this to this very quickly.
Interesting. It's nice to have something. I mean, I'll tell you, like, these case numbers have been, and I struggle with it because it's something we report every day, but I feel like we're just throwing up numbers sometimes where just the context, you don't know. I kind of use the case number of, like, if it's over 400 new cases, that feels like a big number compared to what we've generally been reporting.
Right, but it might not feel like a big number next week or maybe not 2 weeks ago. So unless you're following this every single day. So, you know, it's also even caused us to kind of take a look at how we report too, especially as we have more testing available.
It's good. It's good. You know, great. Out with cases, in with percents.
Right. More numbers.
Can we have a color code system?
Numbers all the time.
Red alert. We're on a yellow. Like, let's make this simple for people. I don't know.